Now, let's look at how you can make new animations, adding to the ones you already have, or how to get to the animation last rig files. Let's open Steve's rig file. Press Steve Rig. Click OK. And here you can really see how much time you can save with it, because there aren't any animations, just the start position, where we can set up our character and we have a simple stand. Here in the Create New Animation, you can create more animations. There are two ways to do this. You either take this composition and the rest of these compositions and copy them one by one, or override them with this amazing True Comp Duplicator. You can find this True Comp Duplicator on ascripts.com website, and it works with a pay as much you can, which can be nothing as well if you can't afford it, but it can be even $120. If you can, please support this amazing duplicating program. If you download it, you will find the installation guide in the description. You can open it if you click at Windows, truecomduplicator.jsx, and in the pop-up window, you'll see it there. I've already put everything in my workspace to its place. It is really important to select the composition you want to copy, then this composition and all the used footages and the used elements will be duplicated. If you select them, you'll need to add these settings. First of all, you'll need to set the suffix to 001 or to a value that you want to write behind the copied files. I choose the 001. Leave this here empty. It's important to put them in a folder. Now, let's call this folder 001_animation1. It's really important that everything with a prefix underline 1 won't be copied, because there is no need to be more of it. It would only make the file size bigger. I made this template on purpose, so it will have more of these underlined compositions that we'll need only once. For example, the head ones that we really don't need to copy. And besides that, let's set the depth limit to 2, so it will only copy those that have a depth 2 in the project structures. This is also very important, and also that the update expression is need to be set, because it will override those compositions that's name is changed. Select them. It is important to select the composition and click on Duplicate Selected. If that's done, it will say you have 20 items duplicated. And now you can see the copy me 001 was created. Let's say we will rename it to 002 animation 1. And put it in the animation folder. And these elements can just go into the animation elements. And here we have our little characters, just how we want it. Don't forget that you need to set the off final quality to off. In case if you don't have internet connection to download this True Comp Duplicator, you can do the copying manually as well. Even though that's a bit harder. But let's go over that as well, so you'll know how to do it. Let's delete all that we made now. Copy me elements. I'm going back to copy me. Let's duplicate this whole folder using Ctrl plus D. Let's say it will be 002 animation 2. It's important, if we enter to animation 2, then we open this and we can find the used body parts. If we look here, we think these are the used ones. but you can see that it doesn't say it's used. And if you go there, create new animation, copy elements, you can see these were used lots of times. And they are here, because these elements are the ones still in the copy me folder. We have to override these, so it won't use them again. And it will use the elements in the folder belonging to it. You can do that, like taking these out, click on them, just like you can see it there. Exclude item, so these elements that have an underlined prefix won't be included. Here, you don't need to bother with these again, but you'll need to take care of the ones that don't have the underline in the beginning. It's important not to take those that are in the Create New Animation folder, rather these that are in our new folder. Press Alt and bring them over to the selected compositions, and you can see that it has been used one time. So this is the used composition already, and continue accordingly. Pelvis, Alt, Pelvis, Head, Alt, Head. You'll need the body one more time. Pelvis, and Neck. And the rest doesn't matter. You can see it's been used two times already. This one was used once. This one too. You can double check if it's the same in the original as well. Two times. This was used one time also, and this one was used two times. We're awesome. But here's head 3 and head 4. Where will these go? Double click in our animation on the head states and we'll see all of them. It's really important to open this, because here you'll find them multiple times. This also has its reasons why it's like this. But we have to do the same thing now. So we start from the top to the bottom. Head 4, press Alt, change it. Head 3, same thing. Alt, head 2, head 1, head 2, head 3, head 4, head 4, head 3, head 2, head 1, head 2, head 3, and finally head 4. Don't forget to press Alt. That's a really important thing. And then you can see that it was used twice. This was used 4 times. Used 4 times. Used 4 times. You can double check it. It was used twice. This one was used 4 times. 4 times. And used 4 times. And now we have it all ready. We have our new cool composition with animation that you can use already, so you won't need to use or change the composition from earlier. You don't need to modify them, and they won't get mixed up either. So, I hope I could help you with this information. So it's time for you to practice.